Welcome to the User Interface video series. This tutorial describes the dataset functionality available in all GeoStudio products. In GeoStudio, datasets may be defined with the new Dataset Import dialog. This dialog allows for the easy definition of datasets, which may include multiple columns of data. The parameter associated with each column may be selected from a drop-down list, as well as the units of each parameter. Importing datasets is the preferred approach for defining functions comprised of significant amounts of data points, which is often the case with field data collected by a data logger. This project was designed to consider the influence of climate and vegetation on slope stability. In order to do so, we need to define the land-climate interaction boundary condition in the transient seep W analysis. The climate and vegetation functions required for this boundary condition can be easily defined by importing datasets from comma delimited files. To import a dataset, go to Define, Datasets, press the Add button, and navigate to the folder where the dataset file is located. After selecting the file and pressing Open, the Dataset Import dialog appears. The selected file contains 7 columns, with the original headers listed in the first column of this window. The second column in the Dataset Import window shows the values associated with each parameter in the selected file. The third column lists the associated parameter. In some cases, the parameter is automatically selected if the Dataset Import feature recognized the header name. Finally, the fourth column contains the units associated with each parameter. The parameter may be modified by clicking on the row and selecting a different parameter from the drop-down menu. Similarly, the units associated with each parameter may be modified. In this case, the units for time are in days. However, the imported data file may also involve time steps, including various date formats. All of the climate header names were recognized, except for rainfall. Consequently, the Do Not Import option was automatically selected under the rainfall parameter type. To import the rainfall data, precipitation can be selected from the parameter drop-down menu. Conversely, if I do not wish to import the data associated with one of the columns in the data file, I can change its parameter type to Do Not Import. After pressing the Import button, the original file name appears as a dataset, and the imported parameters are listed at the bottom of the Define Datasets window. When defining functions in the various GeoStudio dialogs, I may now select the data associated with an imported dataset. For example, if I go back to the Define Boundary Conditions window, select the Land-Climate Interaction Boundary Condition, click on the Ellipses button beside one of the climate functions, and add a new linear data point function, I can select the air temperature associated with the climate data file I just imported. A spline data point function may also be used with the dataset functionality, but pasting large amounts of data into spline functions can slow the software, making the function definition cumbersome. However, in many cases, the dataset functionality will greatly enhance the responsiveness of the software. For example, when dealing with many years of climate data collected at relatively small time intervals. In summary, the Dataset Import dialog allows for the definition of multiple datasets. Each dataset may include various parameters with flexible unit definition. This simplifies the process associated with defining functions in GeoStudio, particularly for boundary conditions involving many functions, like the land-climate interaction and surface energy balance boundary conditions. Finally, using datasets to define functions with large amounts of data ensures that GeoStudio will be more responsive and therefore provides a better user experience. For more information on GeoStudio and its features, please look at the example files and other tutorial videos on the GeoSlope website. Thank you for watching.